morning, and thank you all for joining our new Quick Bite series. My name is Madeline Holzer. I'm the Education Event Specialist here at Zahn, and I'm happy to present Chris Rose and Miguel Gomez from EnvisionTEC today. Chris is the Director of Dental Channels and Sales of North America, and Miguel is the Tech Services Manager of North America EnvisionTEC. We will have time at the end of our Quick Bite segment for Q&A, so please type your questions in the chat and we'll be happy to address them as time allows. Welcome, gentlemen.
Hello.
Hey, thank you. Welcome.
All right.
Today, Miguel and I just wanted to offer you kind of a high-level quick bite of... go ahead, Miguel.
No, you're good. I think there's a little bit of a delay, but...
Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay. So again, thank you all for joining us. Miguel and I just wanted to offer a quick bite of speed, accuracy, and simple ways to maintain our printers. Miguel, if you can advance to the next slide. Miguel, thank you. Okay, well, this is me, folks. Go ahead to the next one, Miguel. So one of the things that we want to talk about first is speed. This is a visual of our EnvisionOne printer actually producing a full plate of parts in under 24 minutes. As many of you may know, printing times can vary based off of the size and orientation of the parts as well as the materials. The EnvisionOne is a very, very fast printer. This will allow you just to give you a visual of 10 to 14 drill guides in an hour, 8-10 denture bases in under an hour. We even have some newer materials that will allow for orthodontic horseshoe models that you might use for a clear liner to be produced in well under 15, 20 minutes. And again, at a very, very high level of accuracy. Miguel, can you go to the next slide? So in addition to our EnvisionOne, we also have the D4K. This, if you will, is maybe the baby brother to the EnvisionOne. It is just as dimensionally accurate, very high level of resolution. This is a native of 50, and with our pixel shifting, we can actually realize 25 micron resolution in the X and Y. Build platform is a little bit smaller, and it's not quite as fast as the EnvisionOne, but this is still an extremely fast printer with a large, generous build platform. So where we might fit 6 to 8 orthodontic horseshoe models, the EnvisionOne, the D4K will allow us to do 3 to 4, but again, very, very fast printing, similar here at 10 to 14 drill guides in an hour. Models, again, you'll be well under 20, 30 minutes, depending on the size of the model. And we also can vary our layer thickness from 25 microns to 150 microns in Z. Miguel, next slide, please. So here you see a comparison when we talk about accuracy. Many, many people confuse microns of resolution, whether we're talking X, Y, or Z, with accuracy, and it's really two different conversations. So the graph on, or shot on the left is a part that was printed on the D4K at a 50 micron tolerance using E-model light material. You can see here that we are achieving a 96% accuracy. However, on the right, you see a competitor printing the exact same model at a 50 micron tolerance, only achieving an 89% accuracy. We have many, many comparisons and white papers and other technical data on how accuracy varies from resolution and this is an important subject that we can, happy to take a deeper dive into later. Miguel, next slide, please. So we have many, many different materials now in our portfolio, and it continues to grow. In addition to speed and accuracy, we like to have a wide variety of materials in our portfolio at a very aggressive competitive cost range. So you see we have dentures, various models. Our denture cost for upper and lower is only around $15. I do like to always add that 3D printing has a certain amount of fuzzy math. Depending on the material, depending on the size, is going to affect the amount of material used. The speed, of course, is the bigger the part, the longer it's going to take to print. We also have various model materials, like you'll see here, where you could do models, ortho models, removable dies, and the average crown and bridge model we now have at around $2. Indirect bonding trays have become popular. A lot of different crown and bridge wax ups for partial frameworks, surgical guides, hard and soft night guard bite splints. And one thing that's important to point out is when all of the parts come off of an EnvisionTEC printer, they're 97% cured. So the post-processing that happens with these materials, once you remove them from the printer, is no longer an hour or more, it's minutes. We pop the parts off the printer, give them a quick bath in alcohol, then depending on which light curing unit you use and what material it is, it again can be as just a few minutes. So we've now taken the post-processing down to 7, 8, 10 minutes, depending on what, you know, parts we're using, what materials, what post-processing, light curing units, such. So a wide variety of materials. One material that we don't have on here yet that's kind of exciting to talk about is our new Aqua model. This is an ortho model material. It'll be designed for suck down for clear aligners, Essex retainers. It no longer needs an alcohol bath. You're actually able to pop this off the printer and wash it in water. So this is just one more game changer of a material that EnvisionTEC has coming. And one little secret that we're proud of, I guess it's no longer a secret, but a week ago this past Friday, it was announced that EnvisionTEC was acquired by Desktop Metal. So EnvisionTEC being the leader in plastics and polymers, now being part of the Desktop Metal family, which is the leader and offers the fastest printers in metals. It's going to be neat to see what we're offering you in the future in the dental space, now working with metals. So next slide, please, Miguel. Oh, hey, we're on to you.
yes.
Well, this is where it gets interesting, folks, because Miguel is going to be able to tell us what you really want to know, and that's how to work with these materials and or maintain the equipment.
Awesome. Thank you, Chris. Thank you. Hello, everyone. My name is Miguel. I'm the tech services manager here for EnvisionTEC in North America, and I'm going to be going over, like Chris said, the maintenance of the equipment here. So I'm going to jump over to the next slide. The biggest thing I want to highlight in this presentation is the new EnvisionTEC Support Center. So our content team and our technical writers have put a lot of work into this website. The main reason is, as you all know, we used to have this website. It's still live, but we're trying to kind of move away from it and into something bigger and better. We used to have this thing called eTeam, where our customers could log in, create an account, look at certain documentation, ask questions, and almost like a forum. So now, what have we done with the help.envisiontech.de site? Well, we've taken all of the information that will help our customers set their printer up, cure their materials, learn about the software, learn about the resins, learn about the accessories, all of that, and made it into a public site that absolutely anyone can access. You no longer have to type in credentials. You don't have to go through an excruciating registration process, login process, nothing. You just type in the website. and boom, you have all of this information at your fingertips. So jumping over to the next slide, you can stay completely up to date with all of our documentation. There is blog posts, there's comments about new features, things coming down the pipeline when it comes to the software, hardware, materials. And on top of that, if there's ever, for example, a new development with machines, or if there's a new development with accessories, all of this information is again here on this website. We have now launched the D4K Pro this past year. It's been an exciting time seeing this printer, you know, leave the shelves and going into, chairside dental labs and dental offices. And what we've done is we've taken the entire installation process from start to finish. We've updated it into our support center site, and we've actually added videos for every single step of the way, from, as you can see from the earlier presentation, when Chris was talking about the D4K Pro and how fast it prints, you can see a video of someone opening up a bottle and pouring in resin. Literally, we go down to every single detail with this printer, how to put in the material tray, how to add resin, how to start the job, how to power it on, how to plug it in. Every step of the way, every step of that installation now has a video. So again, this is an extremely, extremely resourceful site. It has a lot of information. And again, all of it is going to be basically staying up to date. Also, if you are missing any documents, or if you want any of your any documents, every single tab. So if you go to the EnvisionOne directory, so if you go to the website and click on printers, click on EnvisionOne, on the left where all the tabs are, you will see a user documents section. So if you click on that, it will give you every single document that is available to our customers, from the start guide to the maintenance guide to the site prep to everything. All of the documentation that you should have is on there. Now, I would like to talk a little bit about, again, the actual maintenance. So all of the maintenance instructions, again, is I want to point you to that site, and you will have all of the information there, plus some other information that is very useful. But cleanliness. Cleanliness is the absolute most important part of keeping a printer maintained. There is nothing better than, following up with the customer, just to see how they're doing. We have a lot of plenty of local customers here. We'll drive down to a customer site just to check on things, see how things are going. You walk in and the printer looks like it almost better than when it was new. Customers keep their printers really clean. All of their components are clean. Resin isn't on the front cover of the printer. Resin isn't on the hood. It literally looks brand new. And those printers just run. Like they just work nonstop. When we do see issues, for example, issues with quality. The quality of my models is starting to deteriorate. I'm seeing an issue with splitting. The first thing we say is are all of the lenses clean? Are the optics clean? And is the bottom of that material tray? If you look here in the presentation, I am showing here the glass panel that's on the bottom side of the EnvisionOne material tray. This glass is accessible by your fingertips. If you have gloves on and you grab your tray and your gloves have material on them and you put your fingerprints on the bottom of that tray, that oily residue from the resin is going to stick to this glass, and you're going to have to go down there and clean it up as best as possible. Now, again, even if you're careful, you set it down on a cloth, that cloth has resin on it, again, you have smudges. We recommend 100% to clean this out, or anytime you touch this tray, we recommend to just pour it all out and make sure, pour it back into the bottle, wipe it clean, flip it upside down, spray alcohol on a towel, wipe this glass 100% clean, do it a couple of times, and then lastly, follow up with a microfiber and some lens cleaner. This will guarantee 100% that your models, your dyes, your every single print that comes out of that printer is going to have that nice sharp detail that you're used to seeing. And it's going to keep, again, the printer healthy. If the printer is well maintained, if you're not having, again, issues with optics, if you're not having any issues with any of these, the cleanliness of the printer, that's going to prevent all of the domino effect issues that can happen later on. Like, for example, if the bottom of this lens is filthy because someone put their fingerprints on it, that can cause, maybe for a model not to print correctly, they don't clean out that model correctly from the basement, then they can damage the basement. So it's all kind of like a domino. If everything is clean, if you treat this printer, and make sure that it's 100% clean, if you spill resin, you clean it up, you clean your the bottom of the tray, 100%, that is the most important maintenance, not only for the EnvisionOne, but for the D4K as well. Keeping that printer extremely clean, making sure you're using it as if it was a high-end piece, because it is a high-end piece of lab equipment. Make sure you treat it like so. But That is it for my presentation. Just to kind of follow up again, main important thing is our help.envisiontech.de site is live and accessible to everyone. Please feel free to roam that website and just check it out. A lot of great information. And that is all for my presentation.
All right. So if any questions do arise, please reach out to a Zahn representative. We'll be happy to get the questions addressed for you. Thank you both again today for this quick bite. And everyone have a wonderful day.
Awesome. Thank you.
Thank you. Bye-bye.